Hello everyone. Today in this lecture we will discuss about the environmental scanning. Right? So the question arises, what is actually the environmental scanning? So environmental scanning can be defined as the process by which organization monitor their relevant environment to identify the opportunities and threats which are affecting their business so that the appropriate strategic decisions could be made in your company. So here in this environmental scanning, we can say that it's a process of gathering, analyzing, and dispensing the information for, you know, tactical means, daily basis decisions, or the decisions which are to be taken for the strategic purpose. So what happens in this, we have to be very much careful for monitoring the organization's internal and internal factors and external factors so that we can have the view of what is happening in the company and we can have the view of the opportunities and threats that may occur in the near future so that appropriate future planning could be done for the betterment of the company, right? So in this, what is the purpose of the environmental scanning? And as I have told you, everything which is being done, like policy, scanning, appraisal, it is all for the efficient utilization of resources. Constant, we have to monitor the resources. No doubt, environmental scanning is being done so that we can have the idea of what would be the appropriate, what would be the, you know, in the near coming, upcoming future, your opportunities could be there and threats could be there, so that the company could absorb those threats and can create those opportunities with the help of strengths, and appropriate the decisions or strategies could be formulated. And next, I have written here as identification of threats and opportunities. No doubt, everything which is being done, it is for the identification of environmental threats and opportunities. Then useful for the managers, no doubt, to take the decisions, and it takes into account more the prediction of the future. Right, so here is about the environmental scanning, and the next is the factors to be considered for the environmental scanning are, here I have written some of the events, expectation of people, issues and trends. So what are the events? Events means important and specific occurrences which are taking place in different environmental sectors, right? So trends means general tendencies or the courses of action along which the events are taking place. Issues means what are the major concerns, current concerns that arises in response to your events and your trends, right? So expectation means what are the demands made by the interested groups in the light of their concern for the issues, right? So here in the approaches of the environmental scanning, few of the approaches are followed, as you can see here, the systematic approach. Means here the data for the environmental scanning, it is collected very systematically, right? So in the ad hoc approach, so here the data is collected with the help of special service and studies to undertake special projects, right? So that we can devise a new strategies for the company. Here the third one, you can see the processed form of approach, means this kind of approach is basically used by the government agencies or the private institutions, right? So here the factors affecting the environmental appraisal are, right? Here you can see the factors which are related to the nature of environment, related to the organization, related to the strategies, and the factors which are related to the strategist. So here, the factors relating to the nature of environment, you can see the complexity, the flexibility, the hostility, the diversity. No doubt the environment is very much complex. It is very dynamic. So you have to be very, you know, flexible. You have to be very acceptable. You have to accept all these factors. So the factors relating to the company or organization are, what is the nature of the company? Age means experience. Size means big, small, or medium kind of industries there. Nature of market means what kind of imperfect or imperfect, or you can say oligopoly kind of. Nature of the products we have to study about. Then factors let into strategies means what are kind of strategies we have to follow, like corporate level strategy, strategic business unit level strategy, or functional level strategy. Then strategist related factors are to be considered, like is the strategist is forward looking, or you can say not risk taker. His experience matters a lot. Their motivation level, their age, their education, their experiences, their ability to take the decision, their interpersonal relations, their interpersonal skills. So these factors are also to be considered while seeing for the factors which are affecting the environmental appraisal. So here next we can see that how we can structure the environmental appraisal. So two important techniques are there to structure the environmental appraisal. Here the first technique is the strategist prepare the ETOP profile, which is called as environmental threat and opportunity analysis profile. And second, you can say this, you can see that SWOT analysis, which is called as strength, weaknesses, opportunities and threat analysis. So here two techniques are being applied for the structuring the environmental appraisal. It is important to structure the appraisal because finally with the result which is prepared by the strategist, it is to be depicted in a very comprehensive or simplified manner. So that's why two important techniques are used, ETOP profile and SWOT. Right? So ETOP profile includes few of the steps for the preparation of it. So here the environment is divided into different sectors, like what sectors are affecting a particular environment of your business. For example, technology environment, technology sector, market environment, customer, supplier, legal, technology, demography, and international. So we have to divide the environment into different sectors. Then we have to see and analyze what is the impact of each sector on a particular, all of your organization. So what is the impact of these if we talk about market environment? So how much market environment is giving you the impact? Everyone knows that market is very dynamic, customer is dynamic, you don't know about the competitors, so you don't know about anything which is happening in the market. So what will happen in the future, you don't know about that. So if we are going the forecast of that, we have to analyze the impact of each sector on our company. Then we have to subdivide each environmental factor into sub-factors that we will discuss, in my second lecture of this environmental scanning. How we will subdivide the environmental factors into sub-factors. Then analyze the impact of each sub-factor on the organization on the factors. Means if we talk about market environment is a factor. So competitors, customer, product, demand, these are the sub-factors of the market. So how these sub-factors are affecting your company, so we have to analyze the impact of those factors also. Then we have to prepare a summary with the help of a chart by indicating high impact, medium impact or low impact, right? So the importance of ETOP profile is basically we can say that a clear picture can be seen regarding the factors are affecting your company. Is it high impact or medium impact or low impact? So it also helps the company to know where it stands with respect to a particular environment or how a particular environment is giving you the impact, either it is high, low or medium. So it basically helps the company to formulate the appropriate strategy so that we can absorb the, so we can avail the opportunities and we can be able to absorb the threats in the future. And everyone knows about the SWOT analysis, basically the company's strength, weakness and opportunities and threat file. So here we have to identify the threats and opportunities in the external environment. Then we have to analyze what are our plus points and negative points of the firm, so that the cornerstone of the business policy formulation could be made very easily. So SWOT analysis determines the course of action to ensure the growth and survival of the firm. So everyone knows that what are the plus points. Plus points means the plus points could be the good reputation, experience, knowledge, data capabilities, comparative advantage, resources, assets, human resources, capable people, staff, financial resources, marketing, quality of the products, your location, qualification, certification. So these can be your plus points, right? So we must know about the weaknesses also, where we can improve. So what is done poorly, what should we avoid, right? So the examples of weaknesses could be the gaps in the capabilities. It can be your financial weakness, it can be your marketing weakness, it can be your technology obsolete weakness. Lack of competitive skills or lack of competitiveness can be your weakness. So opportunities means these create as favorable situation for the company. And we have to see what are the good opportunities will be created in the future. And we have to grasp that. For example, we can say the low rates of land can be like opportunity for the firm. Okay? The government, very liberal role towards the merger and acquisitions, that you can easily go to merge and acquire. So this can be opportunities. Then threats finally means what could be the, challenges could be faced by the company in the near future. And you have to be very careful so that you can be able to absorb those threats in the near future. So you have to prepare a list of threats that should be able to answer. So you must know what obstacles do you face? What is your competition, right? So do you have any financial problems or not? So we have to be careful regarding all these. So in this lecture, we have gone through about the environmental scanning, the factors, the two techniques we have discussed, that is ATOP profile and SWOT analysis. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the pest analysis and all the environmental factors which we will discuss, which we have to discuss, like all the sub factors of environmental factors, how we will divide the environmental into different sectors. So that's all for the today's lecture. Thank you so much.